There's a question for Kellyanne.
My question has to do with President-elect Trump's communication strategy, specifically if he's going to continue using his Twitter account. I know it breeds a lot of authenticity, but he's also been known to tweet out falsehoods and other liabilities. So is that something that he plans to do after inaugurated?
So that's going to be up to him, the Secret Service, and others who have to help decide those issues. I will tell you that the president-elect looks at his social media accounts, a combined 25 million or probably more at this point, users on Twitter and Facebook as a very good platform through which to convey his messages. I can tell you firsthand that there are posts that he makes that otherwise would not be heard or seen by those 25 million people but for him posting them. But, you know, he's a unique person who's been following his instincts and his judgment from the beginning.
I think one of the points that I think we'd all be interested in hearing is, in the last week, he tweeted that there were millions of fraudulent votes. There's no evidence that there were millions of fraudulent votes. I don't doubt that there were some fraudulent votes. There always are. But the idea that the only reason Hillary Clinton won the popular vote is because of millions of fraudulent votes is not true. And then when CNN reported on that, he started retweeting people criticizing Jeff Zeleny, our reporter, including a 16-year-old boy. And I think the question arises, in a room full of people who want President-elect Trump to succeed, who want him to realize a vision where there are more jobs coming into this country, where you do achieve so much of what you want to achieve, is that really presidential behavior?
Well, he's the president-elect, so that's presidential behavior, yes.
So the things that Bill Clinton did in the Oval Office that you criticized, those were presidential?
Are you actually comparing what Bill Clinton did in the Oval
Office with a Twitter feed? You're saying if the president does it, it's presidential.
Should we review for those who weren't born then what President Clinton did in the Oval Office?
I'm saying just because a president does something doesn't make it presidential.
Yes, I wasn't saying otherwise. But the fact is, this man is now president of the United States. And he's tackling very big issues, the ones that he campaigned on and the ones that he will execute through his first 100-day plan. I know him very well. I'm a trusted advisor. He is committed to making good on the promises and frankly, the plans. And he's going to be focused on that. We need to move on and support the president and the initiatives that he's going to make. I don't like a lot of things that people in leadership do, but they're there. And that should be respected. I mean, I was raised to respect the office of the president and its current occupant, no matter who he or she is.
Jake, I just hope moving forward from this campaign, you know, Kellyanne is right. The campaign's over. It's time to move on. I just hope the truth doesn't get lost or sacrificed.
Hillary Clinton's campaign blames FBI Director James Comey for her loss, but it was the revelations of the email scandal that behind the scenes split her top advisors. We'll have more on that next.